That hide is super, super, super thin. What do you want to do with the meat or anything?
I'll take it back and use it okay. for whatever.
There's gland and stuff in the carcass that you can also, which you know all that. This is the only cut that I make on
them. Right straight up the middle.
Yeah, right straight up the middle. And I also do that because, you know, sometimes down the road, yeah, you might tan it, but you might decide if you want to mount it. And if you do decide that, it's already prepped.
Okay.
To do so. And, you know, I ain't cut your legs off of pieces. You know, there's got to be a lot of sewing left to do there, so.
Well, that cat pattern is unreal, isn't it?
Beautiful. But that's as far as I go whenever I actually make it an incision on one. That's the arm. Again, try to stay above, or you will do what we did there a while ago. You cut a little hole in it. Take your time. These bone through there. Okay. Now, this front pile is a little bit harder than the back piles.
Are they?
Yeah. They're just a little bit tougher. So just have to work. Which, you know, is it? What do they call it? A dew claw or whatever?
Yeah.
Up right there?
That's what I always call it.
Yeah. And we'll get to it here in a minute. You'll see. That's it right there.
Man, that meat is unreal beautiful.
That's pretty. You must have had him by a foot.
I did.
See, it kind of up a little there. Yeah, there's that claw right there. I always just, when I get to that claw, I'll cut that claw, and it allows the rest of you, you know, the rest of it to come on down. The hide is so thin, you can just pull right through it. It's your limber, anyway. And they're, you know how thin their hide is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, literally, like paper.
Worries me, yeah.
They're paper thin. When I get in here, this leg, I'll show you, it'll just pull. I don't have to use a knife or anything at all. It just pull right out.
See, that's my problem. Detail work is my biggest issue.
You gotta watch, too, because pulling that hide. They'll rip. And
yep.
They're so thin. The hides are so thin, man, you'll tear a leg or anything right off. And don't get me wrong, I have done that. You know, I've made those mistakes before and done it. Easy done. See how thin that hide is?
Mm-hmm.
I can almost see my finger through the other side. That's a beautiful cat, though. I take my hand, my finger.
Mm-hmm.
I push around it. I work the hide underneath it. What sometimes my, like my fingers and stuff.
You want that gland?
Nah. You know what? I don't even know, to be honest. If I
don't even talk about that. I've been so busy,
but now my kids love it. I'll take it right there in my hand. Push it knee too.
Look at that. Why can't I do
again,
that?
Again, you can just pull it with your fingers. There's the other side of it. Okay, now I got his leg. Just pull it. Now right here's where you gotta be careful.
That's what I'm talking about.
Because you'll pull it right off of the leg. I just kind of have to assist him a little bit. See how that line right there with the hide and the actual bone and stuff? Don't cut close. Cut above it right in here.
Okay.
Cut.
Don't stay on the line. Stay above the line.
Stay above it a little bit.
Right.
You got to really watch it when it starts to resist.
Stop.
Ease up and help him a little more there. I'm trying to go all the way around it. But stay above that line. See, I'm almost down to that knuckle in the foot there. Just keep working it. See, right there, you can see his knuckles. They above it a little bit there. Now his pad is under here. Now, down almost to the tips of the, right in here, what you want to do is take it all the way down to the claw. And the important thing is to stay above that line, above it, because if not, you'll cut a hole in your fur.
Yeah, I've got a code. I've got to stitch.
And I'd rather
about 5 or 6 times.
Yeah, if you can stay above it, it'll save you a lot of sewing. I'll take my fingers and push through him in his axle fingers.
Mm-hmm.
Now allow you to get it on out just a little bit more toward the end. His claw. See, you can see his claw right there. That's his claw. So you're about as far as you can go on that one.
So go down to the claw.
I do.
Okay.
You know, it's, and again, later on, if you want to taxidermy it, it's prepped already. Just take your old pair of snips or something other, and I go all the way to the claw. And that one is done. Just keep working your way around. I'll use my hand a lot. I'll push it. Now I push it up under the hide. Keeps me having to pull the hide itself.
Right, okay. So that's my issue. Pull.
Well, you can. A good mature cat, they're a little tougher. But a young cat's a little different.
So one question for all the people that might see this. Have you ever eaten Bobcat?
Oh, yeah. I've eaten.
Is it good?
It's shocking.
Everybody tells, look here, you're hearing it from the man himself. Because everybody tells me, what are you doing with your Bobcat? I said, I'm using for bait.
No.
You're wasting.
You ask my wife right there, come. Ask her a question there. She brought me some coffee.
Sis,
he brought me some coffee.
Sis, have you tried Bobcat?
Have I?
Is it good?
It's good.
Hey, every Bobcat that we catch, I process it like I do a deer, a turkey. Look, that looks like a big turkey leg.
That's what it looks like.
That's what that looks like.
That's good looking meat. That's good looking meat.
Take these legs and these shoulders off and take your back straps out. That's all it is.
But where he's been in the freezer, I probably wouldn't do it with him.
But that's what we do with every cat we
catch. If it was a fresh catch.
Every one of them. I don't waste one of them.
See, everybody was telling me, brother, you're wasting meat.
Yeah, they're good eating. I tell you what I do is when I get it out of
Yeah.
But you don't want a real, real sharp knife. I don't anyway. I don't like to give any chances. And I pull that head all the way down to them ears. You'll know when you're there because you'll get just a little bit of resistance. Okay, right there's the ears.
Right. Now that's
both sides.
Mm-hmm.
Now I come by all the way back here toward the back. Ear holder. There's that ear. Same thing other side. Don't cut up in here because you know you want to save that ear bud as much as you can save. It's far down, especially if you ever decide you want to mount him.
Right.
You know, you got that whole entire ear button there. But right to where it points there, you cut through that ear hole. And you'll see when we flip him inside out, his whole entire ear bud's there. There's his eye. You know, a cat ain't got a real deep tear duct like a deer or anything does.
Right.
That's his jaw. You got good light on that phone?
Yep.
Again, kind of like, act like that's fur. Like, because you want to save all this. This is your tucking material and your eyelid
mm-hmm.
and stuff is behind that. So you don't want to come in here and cut here, because then if you decide to mount it, you ain't got enough material for your eye, for the taxidermy to do the work on the eye. So I try to stay up close to this eye socket. This is your eye socket right there. Try to stay as close as that as you can, and you'll see it start to kind of bleed through just a little bit. When it does, just make you a little slit in it. I always stick my finger and it kind of help pull. a lot of times, instead of coming down with your knife, when you get toward the point there, you know, you can come up with it. And there's your tear duct.
Staying beyond this side.
Give yourself plenty of room there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Same thing on the snow here. Stay it way up high. And a lot of times I'll even cut through the eyeball itself.
Yeah, I've done it before. But it was totally on accident. It wasn't because I know what I was doing.
But these tear ducts and stuff right here.
Tough.
It's important if you're going to mount it. It ain't as important if you're not going to mount it.
Mm-hmm.
But still, you know, you don't want to butcher it. And this is his jaw. When I cut that jaw up, I put my finger in it and give it a little tension on it.
Mm-hmm.
All the way down toward, and I try to stay as top to the gum line as I can stay. Again, with like the material and stuff, if you ever want to mount it. Cut that jaw, I always put my finger in it. And I help pull down on it. And stay toward the top of that jaw, kind of close to the tooth. Get it around the cage, I don't know what it's going to come right there. That bottom lip, it's close. Get him around that one tooth. This is the only spot that it really kind of slows down. You want to slow down on your face. Because you don't want to really make a whole lot of mistakes there.
That's the first thing everybody looks at. If
face
it's
is the vocal point. See the bottom lip off, you know.
Yep.
And there's plenty of tuck. Now, right here, you get down to the nose.
That schnooter, yeah, that's what's
you know, you got your cartilage and all that in there. And you'll know when you get down to the cartilage. You don't want to cut through it nose pad or nothing. Cut straight down through the cartilage. And just work it all the way down to the top of your teeth there, the top of the gum line.
Boom, baby.
I did. Nose pad.